you know, I'm like,
she's always been the perfect example of how to drink in every drop of life, every day of your life. No matter what has come Heather Walker's way, her multi-million dollar smile shines brighter than the sun. Heather's journey began in Manchester by the sea. Life leads her to Stephen, her husband. They have two beautiful daughters, Samantha and Taylor, a lab named Lexi. And Heather has worked for the Boston Celtics since 2006, now the vice president of PR. A solid life, but it hasn't been perfect.
My dad got cancer and leukemia when I was 17 years old. He wanted to keep it a secret.
But Heather doesn't want to keep anything secret.
This is cancer, right? And this is the real life.
She has been diagnosed with a rare and aggressive form of brain cancer, glioblastoma.
This is what we're going through.
It all happened this summer.
I got a terrible headache. They did a CAT scan, and they told my mother she has a mass on her brain.
A gut punch.
Are you kidding me? Like, this is not real. Like, this can't be happening.
Heather had surgery at the Brigham. She had radiation, chemo, a ring of the bell to signal the end of that. And right now, she's enrolled in an MIT glioblastoma research study led by Dr. David Reardon, her neuro-oncologist at Dana-Farber. She's been waiting for the green light to begin that treatment. And right in the middle of our interview, this happened.
Yeah, anyways.
And I'm not, we just got your back.
What happened?
Her doctor.
Come over and sit next to her. What happened?
The vaccine just came in that she's going to be taking from Dana-Farber.
Hi, Heather and Stephen. TGIF and good news, your vaccine will be ready. We're scheduled for your first doses the week of 11/8. Stay tuned for more info soon.
Yeah, that's what's going to save my life. I just feel so bad for everyone. I just want cancer to go away. Just, God, help us. There's war, and cancer, it shouldn't be here anymore. And we can do it. We can make it go away. But we need people to help. Because, you know, it's not fair. It's not fair, and there's so many people that have had cancer and have gone through it and are in remission, and they don't talk about it.
Which is why, in the middle of her battle, Heather wanted to help other people too. Those closest to her helped start the Move for Heather Challenge, hashtag M4H, to benefit the Heather Walker Fund for Glioblastoma Research at Dana-Farber.
Do what moves you. It can be anything. It can be a small little hike. It can be my mom's friend just made this like gorgeous quilt.
All money raised will go directly to Dr. Reardon, who is conducting that glioblastoma research study at MIT using immunotherapy and personalized vaccines. And in true Heather fashion, that can help so many other people. Hard times show true friends.
I want to wish you God's blessings upon you and your family.
Just want you to know that we're pulling for you. We love you.
I'm so appreciative of all the support. Like, you know, when you're me, like, I just want to give back to everyone. It's like, there's no doubt in my mind that we're going to cure it. And I want to stay alive so I can help people. And that's my number one thing in my life is helping and also seeing my girls grow up.
See my girls grow up.
Oh, Heather. So that's the thing, Ed.
Yeah.
She kept saying over and over again, flanked by her mother and her friend and best friend and her family, how can I help other people?
Right.
And I just thought, wow.
Sharing the story. I mean, you know.
Who is this woman? And that's who Heather really is.
Yeah. I'm just... Heather, we're all pulling for you. We love you.
We do love you.
Yeah, man.
We love you. By the way, we have all of the information, and this is really important to Heather and her family, on how you can join the Move for Heather Challenge. It's on our website, WCVB.com. It's on our mobile app, and they would love you to go and do exactly what it is she said. It really will make a difference. She believes that. New Center 5, by the way, at 5 p.m. tomorrow, we're going to take you inside that breakthrough cancer treatment and how a vaccine could be used to treat tumors in the lives that could change here and across the country.
It is the number one thing that I wish that we could come out to the news one night and say, boom, cancer is gone. Boom, it's out of here.
Yeah.